We got moderate damage. 7 previous owners. 270,000 miles.
This
is the ugliest vehicle ever.
This can't be real.
This is real. This is you.
This is the best day of my life.
So, let me ask you, I have a question to ask you guys. What do you get your friend that has given you so much that already has everything? Kind of a tough one. Most of you may not know this, some of you do, because you know, you've followed along since the NRPM days. But my very good friend, Mike Tornabene, AKA Dom Mazzetti, was a absolutely integral part of me being able to do what I do now. Basically, dude gave me an entire career. But more so, more than the career, he was the first person that I really met that made it seem like this is possible. And I mean that from a perspective of, I became friends with somebody that was doing this thing that just seemed like vaporware. The whole, you can create anything you want to, put it on the internet, and somehow make a sustainable living from it. Exactly 10 years later, here we are. Because of Mike, because of Dom Mazzetti, I have an entire career, which is a dream. So I wanted to do something special for my friend here. I remember one of the times when I first got into learning how to use a camera, I was interviewing people that I had met that created something from nothing because I found it fascinating. Mike was one of those people early on. I remember him telling a story about the very first time that he realized what he wanted to be, something that was a pivotal moment in his life. Actually, here, let Mike tell the story.
Back in the day, Jersey Shore, riding my bike, cruising for pussy, not talking to girls because I'm 12 years old and I had never been in the gym before. So where's my confidence? Got none, all right? But we're cruising around anyway, looking for chicks. And then we see these like studs, right? They roll up in this white Escalade EXT pickup. And I'm like, these dudes. And right there, I saw my future. Bunch of Guidos in a Cadillac, just scooping up Tang. And me on my bike, just a loser, not doing. That was my goal. That was my 5-year plan.
So that got me thinking, what do you get somebody that's got everything? You get them their childhood dreams. So that's exactly what we're gonna do. And with the help of my good friend, Vinny Anatra, who is arguably the king of buying used cars at absolute dirt cheap rock bottom prices, we're gonna go make Mike Tornabene's childhood dreams come true. Let's go.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Yo! Oh my god!
Did you just wreck your white shoes?
No, I wore the shitty ones.
That's aggressive for this weather, dude.
All right, Vinny, I need you for something.
I know you already told me, but I don't really understand it.
You're just good at buying used cars. You're really good at haggling people down, right?
Oh no, now, you're bringing me along for the lowball.
Yes, this one is choice. I just looked up the Carfax, by the way, so I'm gonna read it off to you in the there. Basically, we're gonna get a car from Mike. It's his childhood dream. It's an 05 Escalade EXT.
Okay.
Yeah.
05. All right. I was expecting you to say like an IROC Z. Not as cool. Dude, IROC Z is the Jersey Shore cruiser, dude.
I guess an IROC Z didn't change his life, hence why he turned out the way he did. You want to go do this?
Yeah, all right. So since it's an 05 and we're in California, one thing you always want to bring when you're buying a used car, OBD2 scanner. Because what you could do with this is check and make sure that all the monitors are ready, because the thing people do with cheap cars, especially if they're trying to be sketchy, is right before you show up, clear the codes. So it doesn't have a check engine light, but then you drive away and it won't pass smog and stuff. So plug this in, you could check it, make sure everything is green. This way you could just like hop in it, get it smog, drive it. If it doesn't, and they cleared some check engine lights, hit them with the offer.
There you go.
Yeah. So I left my race car on the trailer overnight and it rained. Do you want to see how much water is inside this thing? I'm terrified to see. We're swimming back there. Oh my Recaro seat.
Oh, dude. Where is it leaking
look
from?
Look at that. Everywhere.
Oh
my god.
Bro.
That puffy.
How is it leaking that bad?
Because the sunroof doesn't have a seal.
Oh,
god damn it. Do I even put a window in? It's a process. You gotta.
Yeah. Race car stuff. How do you do that while you're in the car?
These are just transport windows. Because, you know, like if you don't have windows on your car, if it's in a parking lot or outside, like someone's gonna go through it. So these at least look like a deterrent.
Damn, driveway's looking hard, bro.
Always, dude. The only thing I got.
Of course, Raptor number 7.
And for all you guys who are watching that want some advice on buying a used car, never do it like this. Buying a car in the rain is the absolute worst idea, because when a car's wet, it generally looks pretty nice. So if you care about what you're buying aesthetically, don't do it. Don't buy at night. Don't buy in the rain.
the C10, I bought at night. The next day after owning it, saw it in the light and found so much damage.
I remember that. You pulled it into the shop and you were like so disappointed. You're like, oh, what did I do with this thing? But it turned out sick. But yeah, don't buy a car at night. Don't buy a car in the rain. Bring an OBD2 scanner if it's 96 plus. We'll show you some other tips of what to look for.
Yeah, here's another really important thing. Always check and make sure that the VIN is not, like, it's clear and it's not stolen. And just buy the Carfax report, right? Like, shit, I'll show you. I just bought one on this truck and it's hilarious. So,
do that. I want to see that. But also another good tip. A big thing that I see with, like, Craigslist marketplace flippers is title hopping. So they'll buy this car at auction or they buy it for super cheap and then they're selling it to you and their name doesn't match up on the title because they like paid $500 for this car, put like $2 worth of work into it and then they're flipping it. Always try to see if like the person's name on the title is the one that's selling it to you is like a pretty good tip.
So let's check out this Carfax.
You ready for this Carfax?
Oh my gosh. 7 previous owners.
Uh-huh.
270,000 miles.
Uh-huh.
270,000.
Yeah.
We got moderate damage. It's a rear, so like this is pretty common. I wouldn't stress that. Oh, it's got two.
Yeah, it's got three.
Okay.
2005, but it was
so
reported.
A little tap. A side is kind of a bummer because that means like doors and body panels were painted.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, this one happened early on in its life.
Yeah, see?
Which is interesting because if it happens early in its life and it didn't get totaled, it still could have been a pretty major accident because this is like an expensive truck back in the day. These were like
exactly
60, 70, 80 grand.
So another thing, if you look right after that accident, becomes like a leasing company, goes to auction.
Nah, it's not that bad. It's 2 years, dude. I wouldn't worry about that. Because chances are the person who owned this was some Guido. Maybe they just knocked the Italian flag badge off the back and then they had to go through insurance. What else we got?
A lot of it's in North Dakota.
You think it's a rust vehicle or you think it was registered out of state?
I don't know. But it looks like there's like service in North Dakota. So I don't know if there's like, you know, like some.
Oh, yeah.
Fictitious.
So that's, well, that's a good thing, too, is like when you look at this stuff, see where the car has been physically, because sometimes people register cars out of state, which is fine. But North Dakota is a rust state, right?
Yeah. Just a lot of states with snow put a lot of salt down. That's what we're talking about, rust states. So like Utah, really bad one, right? Because they still use salt. In Missouri, I believe they don't use salt anymore. They use some sort of chemical compound, which like cars used to rust really bad there. They don't so much anymore. But like Ohio, holy shit. Indiana, really bad.
Anything in the Northeast, all salt. Salt is really bad for cars, rotting body panels, but worse, all the underbody stuff. So like if you have to work on suspension or any chassis stuff and those bolts are corroded, you're going to have a bad time.
Now, this is why it sucks trying to go look at a car in the rain, because you're trying to get under it. A, you're going to be wet. B, it's going to be all wet underneath. So it's like you're not going to see the rust as bad, right? It's a dry day. Basically, dude wants like $5,900 for it.
59?
Yeah.
No way.
Yeah.
Okay.
So he's like, I'm very firm on the price. And I was like, all right, cool. Well, I got to see it first.
All right, I got a question though.
Yeah.
$5,900. What do you want to pay for this thing? Because when I buy a car, I go to the car and I know exactly what I want to pay for it pretty much before I even make an offer. Or sometimes I'll make offers and I'm like, I won't lowball you in person because I know this is what it's worth. So I know you have a number in mind.
I mean, I don't know. That's why I brought you.
I don't know what these things are worth. Let me look. I'll do some research. This is the ugliest vehicle ever. First glance, it's got aftermarket headlights on it, which I guarantee those are in terrible shape too. They're probably faded out like a MF. The interior gets even better. Like we're in a premium Ford with plastic everywhere. And this looks worse. Those look plush though. These seats do rip.
Oh,
these
they rip so bad. You know,
no, I was saying like comfortable wise.
Oh yeah, no, I was gonna say usually the armrest on those Escalades are like blackened from like people's sweat.
Well, because usually you're coming out of the gym, or you were just slathering yourself with like
tanning oil,
and you just got back in it. But these things are crazy. They're all over the map in terms of price. Like this one's $9,000. This one's $13,000, and they're all like about the same years. I don't know. Zach, come on, dude. Just get Escalade V, dude. Easy.
Yeah, see, okay, first of all, I'm buying this from Mike, right?
Oh, okay.
And while, like, you know, he did me a real solid in life, it's just not as funny if I was to just spend a bunch of money and get him a nice version of this.
Oh, I agree. You shouldn't get him a nice one. You should get him a real crummy one. I would say you should even get one mismatched body panel so it makes his neighbors upset.
Mm-hmm. We might have to mismatch some body panels if this one works out good.
Yeah. All right, let's go see this thing.
All right, let's go.
Also, when someone's willing to drive kind of far to come bring you a car, I'm thinking they're desperate to get rid of it, which means we could either A, lowball them, or B, it's a huge pile of crap. But let's see. Look at this reveal. There we are. What a beaut.
Oh, man.
Definitely won't pass smog.
Is it exempt?
Yes.
And then this has been repainted right here.
Yeah, well, that's what this side was in an accident, so.
Okay. That's not bad, though. For all you folks out there who are going to say that's nothing.
All right, so Zach is going out to do a test drive with a guy. He didn't feel comfortable with both of us going. Rightfully so. We're two big, muscular goons. They're doing that. I'm standing outside in the rain. So let's go back and look at this E36. Man, this thing is great. And if y'all don't know, let me show you what's under the hood. This has a LS3 built by Smedding, the same place that did Zach's big block. 441 cubic inch, 13:1, 716 brake horsepower. She's spicy. She's super spicy. We were just at the track yesterday with this thing, and it might be for sale soon. But it is sweet.
Just bought a slightly clapped old Escalade EXT. And you know what? Honestly, not bad. I thought this was gonna be far worse than it is. It's actually kind of sick. Everything works, shifts good.
This actually rides really smooth.
Let's give it the beans, dude. Fun fact, guys, I actually have known Zach for about 7 or 8 years. He has never once owned a practical, reliable car. When I met him, all he had was this Springer hardtail Sportster. And then he bought and built the C10 and has had nothing practical since. So it's pretty funny that he thinks that this thing's super nice because he's never had like a normal car.
Scoot for 270K on the old 6.0. You know what we need to do? Saws all the f***ing exhaust off immediately.
Is it all-wheel drive?
Yeah.
Oh, man, so you can't even rip Bernies in this thing?
Says who? Bump the tires up to 100 PSI at the shop. Let's see what it does.
Let's go get a nitrous kit.
I actually have one.
Let's go to your shop.
Okay.
Honestly, not bad at all. You know, I think this is going to be hilarious. Now I'm trying to decide whether to give it to Mike like this or get some period correct spree wells for it. I don't know, we'll see. Yeah, I think this was a solid move. So now we just gotta get it home, get it out of this rainstorm. Hell yeah.
Not that bad. Drives great, as great as could be expected from a 270,000 mile vehicle that's, well, almost 20 years old. But everything functions kind of as it should. Starts, runs, drives, stops, shifts good, you know, doesn't overheat, at least not yet. It's honestly not too bad. It would have been funnier if it was crappier because, you know, there'd be a more hilarious reaction. But honestly, this will be good. I think this will play out good as something that we can continue to use in upcoming episodes of NARPM, which are coming back. So here's the deal. In the intro, you know, I mentioned that Mike gave me a huge leg up in getting into this whole industry. Well, some background on that. Back in 2015, I decided to quit my day job and give it a year to learn something like a new creative craft and actually find out a way to earn a living being creative. That's when I picked up a camera and started playing around, learning how to edit, learning how to shoot. Well, I'm not great at the shooting part still to this day, but whatever. But in that time, Mike and I had become friends about a year earlier. With him, I saw that it was humanly possible to actually have a living making YouTube videos or, you know, just creating stuff that, you know, you wanted to do. Through that time, that whole year of quitting my job, I was Airbnb-ing my apartment out in order to make a living and pay for, you know, my expenses. Mike would actually let me sleep in his spare bedroom. I would sit there and like just edit all day. He saw that I was dedicated to it and saw that I, you know, it was something I genuinely wanted to learn. From all that is how essentially NARPM spawned. We went to a track day at a thermal club. You know, we definitely weren't supposed to be there. It was all for like Lamborghini owners and stuff. And we were these two fish out of water, and I made us a little memento video from it, just for us. It wasn't for, you know, to be like posted or anything like that. It was so fun that Mike was basically said, hey, we can make a show out of this. I didn't believe him at first because that seemed completely fucking ridiculous. Well, fast forward a bit, we try it out. That would later become NARPM, but you know, I wouldn't have been able to do any of that had it not been for Mike, A, giving me a shot, essentially teaching me a lot of what's required to like, not just do all this, but like to think about it and you know, how to create this content. But I mean, dude gave me a place to live for a lot of the time. So, you know, I've always wanted to do something fun like this. I've always wanted to get him something that would be like a great gift, but it also had to be hilarious. So I think we hit the nail on the head here. I don't know, we'll find out. We're driving to Mike's right now. It's Easter Sunday, so his family's actually at his house. Oh, this should be good. We'll see how it goes. Oh my, there is a CD left in here, and it is a blank writable CD. Let's see what's on this thing. Oh, no f***ing way. I had the tiger, hell yeah, let's go, baby. Copyright infringement right now. All right, just got to Mike's neighborhood. I told him to come outside, so.
Mike, Zach has something to show you outside, so we gotta go.
Okay. I'm equal parts excited and nervous.
No, no, no. You gotta be kidding me.
What's up, dog? Hey.
This can't be real.
This is real. This is you. This is you right here, guy.
This is my dream. I'm finally becoming the man I was meant to be.
You know, you've done so much for me. Allow me to show you a token of my appreciation.
I'm leaving it parked in my lawn like this.
I mean, it's kind of proper. And look, it matches all your other vehicles just with a slight taint.
Actually, pretty good condition.
It's not bad.
Yeah, like the seats look fine. This is, see, dude, it's so funny. It's an actual pickup truck.
I know.
That's the funniest part. There's like kind of use for this.
I know, right?
A little background on this. We'll definitely play the clip because it's like, I don't think I could tell it any funnier than it was. I told Zach one day that the story of when I saw the guy who I was meant to be, I was a kid riding around on my bike in the Jersey Shore. I had never seen a vagina in real life. I was genuinely concerned I never would. I was probably like 13. And I'm riding around, and I see this dude pull up in this white, this beautiful, like a stallion, white Cadillac EXT. Dude was like everything you'd imagine from the Jersey Shore. He's probably like 17, 18 years old. Pulls up and just starts talking to the chicks that we were trying to like build up the courage to talk to. Just pulls up, what's up, girls? And they just hop in the truck and dip. And I'm like, that guy's my goddamn hero. And I never forgot that. And then I told Zach that. And, shows up with this.
It's because you know what? You've become your hero.
Yeah, I've become that guy. For better or for worse.
You want to test out your new stallion?
I would absolutely love to.
I can't. Here.
Smells nice in here.
You know, it did smell like something was burning earlier. So there's that.
Yep. My desire.
I didn't clean it because, we're in a time crunch. Good. So, yeah.
It's more authentic that way.
Okay. Yeah, just chuck that thing into reverse.
I was like, where's the backup camera?
Oh, there's definitely not.
Yeah. What year is this?
05.
05.
I wanted it to be as period correct as humanly possible.
That actually is. Yeah, I think it was probably 2004, 2005 when that actually happened. That's incredible. Oh, this wood grain, dude.
Dude, the steering wheel's actually kind of dope.
Really nice.
I'm not going to lie.
It's a little loose.
After driving this, I mean,
it's a lot of play.
Hey, it's a Cadillac, man. After driving this for a bit, I kind of want one.
Dude, this is so funny. You've done a lot of funny things in your life, and this is probably one of the funniest.
This one feels the best.
Yeah, this one feels right. This is how NARPM comes back.
This is step one.
God, this is so funny.
This is step one. Now, the best part about it is, you bring NARPM back, now you don't have the massive liability of ruining your own vehicles.
No.
Well, sort of.
Yeah. This matters more than all of them.
Yeah.
I'm going to be so careful with it.
Yeah.
This car put the Jersey Shore on its back. This is the blue-collar car of people from Seaside, New Jersey.
You know what it's missing, though?
What is it missing?
It's missing, like, the Italia badge.
Oh, dude. The
things we can mod on this car.
This is the best day of my life.
Hey.
Is this what it feels like to get married?
No.
Yeah.
This is what it feels like to get divorced.
Perfect. I get the best of all of it without having to do any of it.
Yeah.
It's funny because I wanted to, last year, I wanted to do this for Mike's birthday. I couldn't find one, so we were out at Scottsdale, so I was just gonna buy one in Scottsdale, but I just could not find one in A, running condition, or B, shitty enough to be like somewhat affordable. So here's the funny thing, okay. This has had 7 owners. Yo. It's been auctioned once. It's been in 3 collisions.
It's been condemned by the state.
Salvage title.
No, well, it doesn't have a salvage title. This is a crazy thing.
Doesn't have a title at all.
It hasn't been reported stolen yet, so that's good. Honestly, though, I had no expectation of this actually being able to make it all the way up here. I was going to make Mike come down to my shop, and I was going to reveal it there and just be like, you got to figure out how to get this home because it doesn't run. But it works perfect. Oh, what is that smell?
Oh, it does not smell good.
Is that this?
I would venture a guess to say
it's like it smells like Cheetos and sewage.
Yeah, you know, I love it.
Yeah,
nonetheless.
Yeah, dude. By the way, these open up like the whole back opens.
Oh, what?
So yeah, like this comes down. It's like a f-ing Trans Am, bro. It's like the T-tops come off.
No way.
Yeah.
Oh man, this thing is beautiful.
So it's utilitarian, and the bed's all, you know, like lined and shit. So you know, you could just do stuff in it. It's like, it's kind of a sick work truck.
Yeah.
With Cadillac seats.
We're gonna mod the f*** out of this.
Mike, how does it handle?
Honestly, beautifully. It's so sharp. Like, look at this.
Oh, God, Jesus. By the way, I noticed something on the steering tilt.
Yeah.
It's locked in the perfect position to hit a three-pointer, and the thing is broke off, so you can't adjust it.
Oh, yeah, it actually is. Like, I'm just so naturally sitting. Look at this curve in my arm. I just, like, fell right into this. What is this? What are you beeping for? What is that? Unimportant, probably.
The CD player makes this crunching noise randomly sometimes, so that's something.
Look at this clock. That's quality.
I mean, dude.
Bulgari.
Yeah.
Wow.
And I think it works.
Sort of. If I only knew how to tell time.
Are you gonna pick up these ladies?
Yeah. What's up, ladies?
You know, this is 2024, Mike.
Not in here, it isn't.
To think.
It is 2005 in this baby. Forever. This is what it's like. This is actually more of a DeLorean than a DeLorean. It actually drives pretty nice.
I know, it's not bad.
It's like pretty.
So the crazy thing about these early 2000s GM trucks, right, is they'll f***ing last forever. Like my dad had a Suburban and a Yukon XL that both had over 400,000 miles on them, both from like the early 2000s. Like he had a 2000 and I think a 2004. Both those shits went over 400K.
Back into the yard.
Yeah, this is the perfect bargain spot for this thing.
Oh my God.
So what are your first thoughts?
Ah, dude. This is just the funniest thing in the world.
Stand next to this bad boy so we can see.
Give us the rundown now. Like, what does it feel?
It feels like elegance. It feels like you made it. It feels like success. It feels like you retired early. That's what it feels like. You're just gliding through life. It feels like privilege.
Not gonna lie, on these off-brand Intrada tires, you may retire early from life. I'm pretty sure the one on the other one's got all the chalk on it, so I'm pretty sure it came from a junkyard.
Or like ran through a murder scene. Yeah, this is great. Look at the sidewall on that.
Yeah.
Off-roading in that. Rock crawl.
I'm pretty sure we should jump test it.
I am certain we should. So everyone's been asking, when's the RPM coming? When are you and Zach gonna make some more videos? Mike, why are you the worst YouTuber in existence? Your questions, well, most of them will be answered with this, right here. Thanks to Zach Merkins, my financial advisor and mentor. Strange.
What are you gonna name her?
Ooh, that's a good one.
Ooh, I don't know what you think.
I'm gonna have to sit on this one. You can't rush this kind of thing. Can we get custom badges here? Instead of like L-A-D-E, it just says like Escalade, like L-A-I-D.
Yeah.
That's my Escalade, baby. But like big.
Like much bigger.
Way bigger.
All caps, different font, completely.
Take the T off, put an S in there. The Escalade 6 edition, baby.
Put a waterbed back here?
How do you think you could get a hot tub back here?
Well, I mean, you could just do it the rednecky way and just do like a tarp.
Oh, that's not bad.
Yeah. It's got like tracks as if you're gonna like drive a four-wheeler up there or something.
Maybe we are, man.
We could get like little power wheels.
That would be so funny. And we should.
Yeah. Yeah, we should. It'll probably be more expensive than this.
Oh, the things we're gonna do with this, I can't wait.
You know, there's ample cup holders in it everywhere too. I don't know, here, in the back, two parts in the back. You know, it was meant to party.
This is a pretty cool car collection, I'm not gonna lie. I'm a collector now. Three makes
it fits
collection.
Right in. Yeah. Oh, you should keep this one parked like this too.
I don't have anywhere else to park it, man.
Today is a big day.
It's a huge day. This is probably the biggest day of my life. Everything I've done has led up to this moment. When you retire, you get that gold Rolex. This is my gold Rolex, baby. But I'm not retired. I'm not f***ing leaving.